The Legend of Ngong, the Giant. Long, long ago in Africa, when the land was new, the mountains tall, and the plains were smooth and flat, and when the water flowed quickly to the sea, there lived a giant whose name was Ngong. This was in the time before people forgot how to speak with the animals, when the world was young and legends were beginning to be made. Ngong was a frightening creature, huge beyond belief, Mkubwa sana, and with an appetite that could devour 100 buck at a sitting. He could drink half a river just by damming it with his foot and stooping to gulp up the water. Where he trod, the earth trembled, and when he roared, the sky shook with thunder. Now, the land where Ngong stayed was halfway from the top of the earth and halfway from the bottom. In fact, it was right in the middle, on the equator. And it took its name from the radiant snow-capped peak called Kenya. The animals of the plains and the birds of the air were terrified of Ngong, and so were the men and their families. But the land was beautiful, and as long as the dark clouds rolled in from the sea, there was enough rain. And as long as there was enough rain, there would be fresh green grass on the plain. And as long as there was fresh green grass on the plain, there would be plenty of buck. And if there was plenty of buck, then there was nothing to fear. One year, the dark clouds stopped rolling in from the sea. The rains were late, the grass dried up and turned brown, and only a few buck remained on the plains. Then there grew in the hearts of the animals and men a great fear, a fear that if Ngong the giant was hungry enough, he would eat every one of them up. But that wasn't all. Without water from the rains, the people would die of thirst. Frightened, they all prayed to the god Mungu that he would darken the sky and bring his rain. Only then would the great rivers fill up again, and only then would the new shoots of grass burst forth to feed the young buck on the plain. Living within the shadows of Mount Kenya, there dwelt the families of the Kikuyu tribe. Their chief was a very wise old man named Mzee Kabisa, whose hair was as white as the snow on the mountain. Mzee Kabisa was worried, not for himself, for he had lived a long life and had seen the dry season come and go many times. No, it was for his people that he worried, for his children and his grandchildren, of which there were many. They feared that if Ngong the giant ate all the buck on the plains, then he would come and eat their cows. Then they would have nothing to eat. If he drank all the water in the rivers, there would be nothing to drink, and no water for their crops in their shambas. So being a very wise man, Mzee Kabisa asked all the elders of the tribe to gather together in the shade of a big tree, the Magumo tree, for a meeting. At this meeting, Mzee Kabisa said, "We have Bahati Mbaya, some very bad luck. Mvua, Panakuja, no rain comes. Wanyama Watakwenda, the buck are disappearing. Maji Nakwisha, the water runs to the sea. Labda Ngong Nakuja, and Ngong may come and eat us up." He finished by asking those gathered at the meeting, "Tafanya nini? What shall we do?" The elders sat talking under the big Magumu tree all day long, but they still could not give Mzee Kabisa a good answer to the question of what to do if Ngong came. They suggested that he consider asking some of the chiefs of the other tribes. "Mzurisana, what a good idea," said Mzee Kabisa. So Mzee Kabisa sent his best young runners out to all the different tribes of Kenya to ask if they had a suggestion about what to do if Ngong came. He sent runners to the north, as far as the Turkana, then to the Luo in the west, the Maasai in the south, the Boran in the east, and all the tribes in between. Each of the runners went to the chiefs of the villages and said, "Mzee Kabisa, the chief of the Kikuyu, sends you his greetings. He asks, how are your wives and your children?" This was in the time when men sometimes had many wives and many children. The runners continued, "We have Bahati Mbaya, some very bad luck. Mvua Panakuja, no rain comes. Wanyama Watakwenda, the buck are disappearing. Maji Nakwisha, the water runs to the sea. Labda Ngong Nakuja, and Ngong may come and eat us up." And they finished by asking, "Tafanya nini? What shall we do?" But from none of these tribes did Mzee Kabisa receive a satisfactory answer, except for one.